Hey, hello everyone. So in this video, I will be explaining you what is STL in C++ and what are the uses of STL and why you should learn STL immediately. Okay. And in this video, I'm not going to code anything. Okay. I'm just going to explain everything in words. And the subsequent videos, I'm going to put more videos about STL, like code it, how it works, the algorithms, the containers, the iterators present in STL. So this video is going to be like a full explanation by words. So let's get started. The first question that comes in your mind is, what is STL? So STL stands for Standard Template Library. Okay. So first get the full form. STL stands for Standard Template Library. And STL has like a simple definition. Okay. STL is a template class in C++ and a library of containers, classes, algorithms, iterators. So like you, many of you would have used SQRT function. Okay. This function, square root function, to find the square root of numbers. It's used in like even in Python as well as in C and C++. So for using the square root function, we will be importing something called as hash include math and hash include math.h or hash include cmath.h. So it's basically the same applies for STL also. So here in STL, we will be using hash include bit slash stdc++.h. So using this one header file, we can use all the functions, inbuilt functions present in STL. So STL is basically like a library which consists of many inbuilt functions, okay, in it, and pre-programmed stuff, okay, pre-programmed classes, containers, algorithms, iterators, everything in it. It consists, it's just a template of classes and pre-programmed stuff, and we are just going to use it by using functions. So same way here, we same example as I told you earlier, we used hash include cmath or math.h header file, and we used sqrt. Same stuff applies for STL also. We will be using this header file. This includes all the things, okay? One header file for all the entire, covers entire related classes, algorithms, iterators in STL. And we will be using those inbuilt functions. That's the thing. STL is just a template of library and pre-programmed stuff. Okay, so the next question that comes in your mind is why we should learn STL immediately, okay? And I have like two reasons for that in my personal opinion, and let me show you the reasons. These are like the two reasons what I feel everyone should learn STL today, because the first reason is it reduces the code length, okay? So for example, like if they have given an array, okay, in any like school or like coding competition, they have given you an array and you need to just sort it, okay, sort the array. So what you will do, you will either use bubble sort, insertion sort, quick sort, selection sort. There are like many sorting algorithms. So for each sorting algorithm, depending upon type of algorithm, you need to write at least 20 lines of code, okay, 20, 30, some case 30 lines of code. But here in STL, we have a function called as sort itself. The name of the function itself, sort, and we just pass arr, that is considering arr as the array, and arr plus the length of the array, let n be the length of the array. This single line sorts the entire array just using a single line. So this basically reduces code length and our time of coding. And another thing is that STL does not reduce the time complexity of the code. They, you need to have like you need to pay important attention over here, because usually sorting algorithms, the quickest sorting algorithm takes big O of n log n, that is merge sort, okay, it takes n log n time complexity. And here also this sorting algorithm takes place n log n time complexity, because some kind of this sorting function does some kind of backend operations, okay. And that is that backend time complexity is also equal to our normal merge sort time complexity. So there isn't going to be any change in time complexity. Only our, it reduces our code length. Like if you make any mistake while doing bubble sort, insertion sort, it's going to be like a long process to check the errors and get it right. Instead of just, if you can just put a line, that's it, our array gets sorted. And the next thing is CP. CP is nothing but competitive programming. Like many college students will be knowing that. Because in case like if you want to get placed in a company, you need to know competitive programming and you need to be able to like solve problems within a quick time frame. Like you will only be having 1 hour to solve like 3 to 4 problems in any like in first round. Basically like whatever may be the company, the first round is going to be like a coding round. So you will be given four random number of problems and you need to be able to solve them. And for CP, like to do it in fast time and easy way, many prefer C++, and the main reason for many preferring C++ is because of the STL library present. So I think these are like I think the common opinion like all will have why to learn STL. Not only sort, like you even have queue, okay, queue and stack. So basically for implementing queue, we either use the array method, what we have like left pointer and rare pointer, okay? So we assign them to minus one and we just do it. For stack, we will have a top, assign it to minus one, and for each push of the element, we'll increment top. And we have a pop also, we'll do minus minus. So this can also be implemented by using a linked list, okay, queue and stack. But in STL, we just have a queue, okay, queue, that's it. It's the name of the, it's called as containers, okay, in STL. Similar to array, but it's called as containers. If you just put queue int queue, this will automatically create our queue. Queue, okay, I'm naming this queue. So it will automatically create. So for inserting, we need to put queue.push, queue.pop, that's it. So by using only one line of code, we can just implement our entire queue itself. So that's what STL is really important, why you should understand it, because it just simplifies our coding process and makes our coding work really, really simple. But like in case of like in your school, if they're asking implement queue, you can't use this because there they're testing your knowledge. You should only do by using linked list or by using array. In case of community programming or like any online coding competitions, you can use this STL, okay? And the next question will be, what are the components of STL? So STL basically has four components. One is algorithms, containers, functors are called as the function objects, and iterators. So the most commonly used among these four, I would say, will be containers. Okay, these are like used in all the community programming. Like if you just watch a community programming, you will have at least a vector in it. Okay, there can't be any community programming without vector in it. Okay, so as I told you earlier, let's start with from algorithm. For searching is like, we have two searching, linear search and binary search. We have like a binary search function also in inbuilt function. So if you just type binary function and pass the particular array and the value, we'll be getting the, whether you'll be getting true or false, whether that particular element is present in array or not. Sort, as I told you earlier, sort function, SORT, that array and array length, we'll be getting our array sorted. So this is also, sorting is also applicable for all the containers. So containers, like they are quite similar to array, and here we call vector, okay, array is called as vector. And as I told you earlier, we have stack, queue, and there are like many more. So these many dots I have placed, the main reason is because there are like so many containers. We have priority queue, we have set, we have map, and there are also like different types of map. We have ordered map, multi-map, same thing goes for set as well. So there are like priority queue as well. So there are like many containers. And I have never used functors, to be honest. Like I don't know how they use it, why they use functors. So basically, like, it's just to give some additional functionality to our function, okay? I've never seen anyone using functors, to be honest. And iterators also, they use iterators as nothing but, like, consider an array. Suppose you are using an array. So how you access, like, each element of an array? You use basically I, okay? For I to, I'm just writing the pseudo code. For I to, like, we have read the code, okay? I equal to 0, and you'll put I less than the size of the array, and you'll just put I plus plus, okay? And inside, here you will be having C out error of I. So this is what iterator means, basically like for an array. Same stuff here, okay? We will be having like a separate iterator IT we will declare, okay? Iterator, so we will have like a separate function for iterator, but the function is same thing. So iterator also, it's not that much wide used. You can like even use a vector or a vector by using this syntax. Same syntax, instead of array, you can just put a vector. So iterator also is not that much used to an extent, but the main thing is containers. You will be familiar with the containers because they are like the real king of competitive programming by using C++. And the only reason C++ is used for competitive programming is widely, these containers are the reason, okay? So these are like the main stuff. You need to learn containers, focus on that. If you learn containers, like, you can master competitive programming by using C++. So that's it for this video, and in the subsequent videos I will be like creating so many tutorials, especially on these containers and all this algorithm and stuff. So you can subscribe my channel, and I also have many other videos in C++, C language, Python, Java as well, Blender also, the 3D animation. So you can subscribe my channel and support me, check other videos, and thanks for watching.